All right, well, we finally arrived in Sopron. As you can see already, they have some German signs, being so close as it is to the Austrian border, tucked up in the northwest of Hungary. It looks to be a very pretty city. And there is Marco and Lorenzo. Look at these two Italians dragging their suitcases. Marco, what do you think of Sopron so far?
It's amazing, guys. It's amazing.
Just okay.
Absolute minimal sulfate content made it.
A real mixed Austrian, German, and Hungarian history in the city. They call it the City of Loyalty because after Trianon, at the end of World War I, they had a choice, Hungary or Austria. And they chose Hungary. They chose Magyarország. And forever after, it was known as the Loyalty City. The Fire Tower is really the symbol of Sopron. Built in the 13th century originally, you can see the Hungarian flag draped down from the side there. Reconstructed in the 17th and always a beating heart of the city of Sopron. It's a beautiful fire tower. Very Assassin's Creed.
Ah, Nemzet Sopronnak.
The voiceover.
Oh, come on. Marco, there's no ruining.
In this square during the Middle Ages, if you did something wrong, this is where you got punished. This is where they did the public executions. Amazing. I mean, you can just see the mob descending on the square and baying for blood.
Someone stole a loaf of bread.
Killed. Blood. That's why it's so sloped, probably. The blood could just drain down into here. Huh. Here we are in Kőszeg. Got a lovely forest retreat, a cabin in the woods. And you can see out the window there, the two Italians, Kate Olasferti, standing out over the Bogrács fire.
Oh, it's sunny now.
Very, 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 very creepy as we start our walk out here on Mohás utca, the street of moss. See that? Fucking baby head?
It's quite scary.
It's scary.
Yeah. Frightening. Terrifying.
It's very cool.
Yeah. They call him Pau the Popo. Or what's octopus in Hungarian? Poli. Pau the Poli. What do you see there? Some abandoned properties out here in Kőszeg. Very interesting. Should we go take a look inside? Oh. Very cool. Kőszeg, right nestled up on the Austrian border. A beautiful, beautiful alpine part of Magyarország. A rarity in Hungary to have an alpine location. Wow, this is a fascinating. Kőszeg is an incredibly historic city, being involved in many wars over the years, several exchanges between Austrian and Hungarian ownership. There's Lorenzo, go take a look. It's nice in there. We're entering the forest path here on the way up to the Ohas Kilato Var. It's an old 13th century stone castle. Negyedik Béla took control of it in the 13th century, that brave king who rebuilt Hungary after the Tatai Yarash, and of course was so famous for building the stone castles, although they say that he did not actually build this one, he just commandeered it.
Into it.
No,
Gombak.
No.
Gombak. Say Gombak.
Gombak.
Gombak. Yeah, Gombak.
Horseberry, Marco?
Yeah. It's very sour.
No, it's not good.
Only the Italian fruits are good. Only the Italian fruits are good.
No, man.
Moha, moss. That's why the name of the street is Mohás utca. Because moha is moss. Woohoo! Here we are at the Ohas Var Kilato. Oh yes, a nice stone castle. Look at this thing. So well preserved. 13th century. The handiwork. Phenomenal. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant stone castle. Wonderful kuvar. Say the pot. Hogy va tok? Jó? Gyönyörű. Nagyon gyönyörű. I love a good stone castle. Hey! Oh, what a view! Nagyon szép. Oh, there's the town of Kőszeg unfolding in the midday mist. As I mentioned earlier, Bela the IV did not build this castle, although he may have. They're not really too sure on that fact. But at the very least, he commandeered it in 1248, following the Tatyarash, when the stone castle fortifications became so integral to the Hungarian national security. The Kőszegian forest is very, very rich. You don't get this in many parts of Hungary. Well, you do, but not on such a steep gradient with such an alpine atmosphere. Johangulat. Nagyon, nagyon, nagyon Johangulat. I guess it's actually Jurišić. I was saying Jurišić before. What are you gonna do? Jurišić, of course, that brave, brave Croatian general who defended the castle of Kőszeg against the Ottomans in 1532.
Save Kőszeg.
I love Kőszeg. It's a beautiful town. So quaint, so lovely. Nagyon, nagyon gyönyörű. I've never seen a Hungarian town quite like this.
You see? Percy. It's Percy. Oh. Percy. You know the little pirate? It's Percy.
La Kika was one of
them. Uh-huh.
That was that one. That one.
This
one
is La Kika.
La Kika.
This is La Kika.
Oh. Percy and La Kika. Which one's Lorenzo? Lorenzo could be this guy.
Which is the pizzeria that you were talking about?
Italians always on the lookout for pizzerias. It's a very beautiful old town, Kőszeg. It kind of feels like you're walking within the walls of a museum, even though you're outdoors. Liszt Ferenc, aka Frankie Flower. Look at him.
Nice.
Marco, these are your lands. This is your Szép Város. Marco Kőszegian. Here we are approaching the Kőszeg Castle. Nagyar Kurtanel in 3D. I've actually been to that show in the Buda Castle. It's funny. I like it. I like it. Ooh. Very nice. Is this the castle? I can't even tell. I think that is our brave man himself. Jurišić Miklós. Such a brave, brave, brave defender against the Ottoman incursion in 1532. You can just imagine the siege that was laid to this place. Oh, it's so beautiful. A lovely restored burnt orange, burnt sienna color. It must have been a real feat to withstand the Muslim incursion. Forintos Matyash, Tűzmester, the fire master. Wow, that is phenomenal. He must have been concocting all sorts of fiery bolts and cannons and blasts. Yes. Oh, like Bornemisza Gerge. Bornemisza Gerge. It's really such a nice feel here in Kőszeg. It's a very historical place. You can just feel the history dripping from the walls. And it's well preserved as well. A real appreciation. It doesn't look fake. It doesn't look tacky. It just looks like something that's been respected, as history should be. Especially when the history is as amazing as the Hungarian history. Marco, out of 10, what do you rate Kőszeg?
11.
And Lorenzo?
It's a place where I want to settle down.
The Italians of Kőszeg. A short story. A very short story.
Slovakian beer. Zlatý bazant, the golden pheasant. Aran facan in Hungarian.
Kate olas férfi. Nagyon szép túz.
Szép zene. Ah. It's Bogrács time, baby.
This is onion, and you need a lot of onion. So
step one, hajma.
Onion. Onion is Hungarian is called
hajma.
Like white onion, fair.
Hajma. After the onions, you add the meat, the marha, the beef, the gulyash hush. Dump it in there, Alexa. Oh yeah. All right, here we got some of the other veggies. We got carrot. What's this thing? Radish. Celery. What's this?
It's white carrot.
Turnip. And here you can see The goulash has turned a little bit of a red color, and that is due to the secret ingredient. Not really secret, the secret's out. The most important ingredient is paprika. We've got fushtot, chemege, edesh, sweet, and this is the spicy one. Paprika is potentially the heart, the soul, the lifeblood of the Hungarian nation. Tuzmester.
Oh. look. Look how it changed.
It's amazing.
Fuck.
What's it called? Predsimilo? The smoke. The smoke. This looks like a good goulash. How long have we been cooking? 4 hours?
And we never put the Bogrács on the table, so we always just put it somewhere and everybody
wants to. So like, actually, without this one or with this one?
Huh?
Without not like this one.
It's okay, just like that.
Marco, what's the review on the goulash?
It's like I.
Nice. Bon appetit.
And I mean, I couldn't get enough of this one.
It's so good.
Unbelievable.
Make to second piatto.
Here we are in Balatonfüred, the Reform Catholic Church, getting ready for our final weekend. Oh, yeah, there she is. There's our Airbnb lady. There's the Balaton. Wow, this Airbnb is unbelievable. Wow. Sziasztok!
Sziasztok!
Oh, wow, look at that sunset. Just dipping below the hills. What a timing. What a perfect timing. Woo! Balatonfüred. Color me impressed. Color me very impressed. Jó reggelt, Marco.
Jó napot. No?
What are you reading?
Always the same book.
Mickey Mouse.
Alexa tells me that the Balatonfüred is really the heart chakra of the Balaton. It's got some great energy, magnificent air quality, and you can see just from the spectacular kilatash, the spectacular view, how right that may be. Today we're heading to a vineyard in the region. There's some sort of party there, some DJ. Gonna drink some wine and enjoy the last swan song of the summer. Oh, what a terrific trip this has been. A nice little Széchenyi István statue right here at the edge of the promenade. Wow, Balatonfüred is a lovely, terrific, fantastic part of the Balaton. Never been to this part of the Balaton, the North Shore. Vineyards, music, sparkling water. Oh, the sounds of the Balaton. Accordions, boat horns, swans. This is what it's all about. All right, well, here we are at the Homola Borteras. This is pretty chill. This is pretty unbelievably, spectacularly chill.
It's a deeper
set,
flavor.
Set.
Last day, Balatonfüred. We're here at the fountain, the magic fountain. Some good stinky water. Yinyuru Buddhish Viz. Najanyo. Ooh. Marco, that's gonna be you one day. This is Kurushi Choma Shandor, an absolute maniac. This guy traveled into Tibet, into the Far East, in search of the ancient roots of the Hungarian language. He lived like an austere monk in the middle of like a Tibetan shack. Kurushi Choma Shandor. What a fiend.
He's a poet.
Salvatore Quasimodo.
A poet.
Why is here?
But why is here? Yeah.
Con cuore felice.
We found an Italian poet, Salvatore Quasimodo. What a trip, what a country. What a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful life. Oh yes, Magyar, Magyar, Magyarország. Köszönjük szépen, folks. Köszönjük szépen.
Nagyon szép kilátás.
That's gotta be the ending shot. Grazie, ragazzi. Folks, thank you ever so much for lending me a part of your day. This has been another episode of Walking with Willie. Or, as the Italians like to say,
Camminando
Yo. Grazie, ragazze.